After a storm, individuals normally have meats and perishable foods within their refrigerator. These should be consumed first, and foods which are like crackers and tin foods, these should be left for last, because the foods which are easily damaged or rotten, they won't last very long if they're not refrigerated. So people should use their meats and perishable foods first, and leave other foods like which are like crackers and canned foods, those should be left for last because these can last much longer. What do you do after the storm? It's extremely important to know that water consumption must be something that has to be looked at because disease processes can be transferred via water. Individuals will actually recognize that if they did not store water, they will not necessarily have water in the tap. If you are to collect water from sources, you cannot assume because it looks clean that it's good. The first set of water that comes back to the tap, even though it may look clean, may not necessarily be, because they can be damaged in the main, which can show that they're actually germs in the water. You cannot assume the water in the tap is good for drinking, so water must be boiled. People who collect water from streams it's really, quite frankly, after a hurricane or a storm, it's not the best thing to do. But if you don't have any choice but to collect water from the roof, etc., water must be boiled.
Six a.m. tomorrow, we intend in every single community, every single village, to begin the construction of at least one house. And they're making all the arrangements then, and we will seek to distribute to deserving persons materials for work to be done, and we will assist as far as possible with getting some of the work done. But we have to proceed with great rapidity. So that many persons have to get on with helping themselves too, because we have to get the persons who are in the schools out of the schools in the main, because we want to have people out of the schools certainly by Thursday, so we can clean up on Friday and Saturday, put everything in place. By then water and electricity should be back. We'll have our students back in classes on Monday next.